The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 7th chapter, text number 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 25th, 1975, in Fiji.
I am just going to speak before you about knowledge of the Absolute. It is from the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. This human form of life is obtained after many, many millions of years by evolutionary forms. Aquatics, then insects, reptiles, birds, bees, uncivilized man, and then civilized form of human being. They are called the Aryans. So, the human being, civilized human being, is the topmost of the creation. And the consciousness is developed than the lower animals. Therefore, the Vedanta of philosophy says that this human form of life is meant for understanding knowledge absolute, knowledge of the absolute. Athāta brahma jigyāsa. Brahma means absolute. Brahma is explained in the Vedanta Sutra, janmādvasya jatā. Brahma, or the absolute truth, is there from whom everything has emanated. That must be the original source of everything. So to understand that original source of everything is the knowledge of the Absolute. So this Krishna consciousness movement is teaching throughout the whole world about the knowledge of the Absolute. There is no question of religion or dogmatism. It is a question of cultural advancement in knowledge. Every human being has got right to understand the absolute knowledge. That is the only business of human being. There is no other business. Unfortunately, for want of training, we are wasting our advanced intelligence for the same business as the cats and dogs are engaged. That is it. Cats and dogs, they cannot understand what is absolute knowledge. They are busy where to find out food, where to find out shelter, where to find out a facility for sexual intercourse, and where to find out shelter to avoid danger. Defense, in other words, defense. Ahara nidra bhayamai sunant. At the present moment, the human society is busy where to find out food, where to find out shelter, how to have nice sexual intercourse, and how to defend from other nation or other enemy. This has become the business. This is always the business of the materialistic way of life, but this Krishna consciousness movement is a different life. It is not materialistic way of life. It is the life of spiritual realization. It is a little difficult because people are accustomed to think everything in materialistic way. Just like peace. Peace cannot be possible in the animal or materialistic way of life. It is not possible. You cannot expect peace in the cats and dogs society. That is not possible. Peace is possible when human being is advanced in God consciousness or Krishna consciousness. When you speak Krishna, please try to understand, I am speaking of the Supreme Lord. Krishna means all attract. Bhagavan, here it is said in the 7th chapter, Sri Bhagavan Ubhav. Bhaga means opulence. You use the word Bhagavan, Bhagga. From this word, Bhaga, it has come, Bhagya. Bhagya means fortune, opulence. So Bhagavan means all fortunate, all opulent. That is Bhagavan. That definition is given by Parashar Muni. The wealthiest man, Vaisarjasya Samagras. Vaisarja means wealth. And samagra means all, complete. We may be very rich, you may be very rich, but nobody can claim that all the riches belong to me. Nobody can. Only Bhagavan can say. Just like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram jagatavasam sarvaloka maheswaram. He says, I am the enjoyer of all activities. Just like there are so many different types of activities, but the result of the activity is enjoyed by somebody. He is called Bhokta. That's a very big business establishment. So many activities are going on. But the enjoyer of the result of the activities is the proprietor or the managing director, something like that. Similarly, Krishna says, Bhoktaram jagatavasam. We are engaged in different types of austerities, finances, and performing yogas, but who is the bhokta? Bhokta, Krishna says, I am the bhokta, I am the enjoyer. Bhoktaram jagatavasam saruloko maheswaram, and I am the proprietor of everything within this universe. Not only in this universe, there are many other millions of universes. Therefore, there sarva loka maheswaram. There will be different lokas in each and every universe. Maheswaram, Mahaiswaram, the supreme proprietor. Bhoktaram jagatavasam sarva loka maheswaram Sri Ram sarva bhutana. Although he is so great, still he is friend of all living entities. Sarva loka maheswaram suridam. Gyata maam shanti icchati This is the culture. If anyone can't understand that God is the proprietor of everything, God is the enjoyer of all activity, the result and action, God is the supreme friend of everyone. Simply by understanding these three formulas, one attains real platform of peaceful life. That is, peaceful life. So, Bhagavan Upasana. Oh, we don't say anything which is not spoken by Bhagavan, the Supreme. We don't manufacture concocted ideas, dogmas. No, that is not our business. One should not do that. But if you speak what Bhagavan has said, what Krishna has said, that is perfect. Bhagavan means the supreme, complete, the possessor of all opulences. Aishwarya means riches, strength, influence, beauty, knowledge, finances. These are called Aishwaryas. So, you try to find out who is that person who possesses all these things, bhaga, incomplete. If you are inquisitive, if you are actually philosopher, then you will find Krishna. Krishna is Bhagavan. Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. That is the verdict of the Vedic Shastra. Krishna, so you are searching after Bhagavan or God. We simply try to understand that God is very great. That's fact. But how great He is, that has to be known. That is called knowledge of God. Now we cannot think of that one person can become the proprietor of all the riches and wealth of the world. But unless you accept it, he is not God. So, this understanding of God requires a process. How to understand? The main process is that we cannot speculate about God. That is not possible. If we want to know God by speculation, there may be difference of opinion. I may say God is like this, you may say God is like this. That is difference of opinion. The best thing is to know God from God. That is, let God speak Himself out. That is perfect. If you simply conjecture, guess, that Swamiji may be like this, another may say like that, but if I say unto you, I am like this, that is perfect. So here in the Bhagavad Gita, we have got this advantage, followers of Vedic literature, that the Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is speaking Himself about Himself. That is perfect knowledge. Therefore it is said, Bhagavan was. The Supreme Personality of Godhead is speaking Himself. So, He was speaking to Arjuna. So, he says, the process, how to understand God. The process is means, maya saptamana prartha yogam jinjana madhasraya asamsayam samagramam jathagasasi tachin. Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, says that if you want to know me, then you have to increase your attachment for me. This is the first condition. Mayi asatta mana. Our mind is attracted by so many things, especially in the material world. When Yoga system was advised to Arjuna that you concentrate your mind upon me, Arjuna flatly declined, "My dear Krishna, I cannot concentrate my mind in any particular thing." But he said that I have got my mind on you. That is different. But if you ask me to concentrate, it is very difficult. Chanchala hi mana Krishna pramathi balabhadram tasyaham manne vayure pasudhiskaram tasyaham nigraham manne vayure pasudhiskaram. The yogis, generally the yogis, they are trying to concentrate the mind upon the Supreme Absolute Truth. That is the yogic practice. Yoga indriya sangyama. Yoga means to concentrate your mind to the Absolute Truth by controlling the senses. Because the senses are very restless. It will not allow you to concentrate your mind. Therefore, yoga, indriya sanyama, that is yoga. So here the same yoga is advised. Yoga na jhunjana madasa. This yoga has to be practiced under Krishna. Madasa. Mat means me, and asraya means taking shelter. Or madasraya means to take shelter of Krishna's devotee. One who has completely taken shelter of Krishna, to take shelter of him. The same thing. One who is electrified, if you touch that man, you also become electrified. This is the problem. Therefore, this is stressed here, that you practice this yoga. Maya sapta mana partha. My dear partha. Partha means the son of Pritha. Arjuna's mother's name was Kunti Pritha. Therefore, he is sometimes addressed by the Lord as partha. Krishna's another name is Partha Sarathi. Partha Sarathi because he accepted the post of chariot driver of Partha, therefore his name is Partha Sarathi. There is a very big temple in Madras of Partha Sarathi. So, somebody we fight that God has no name. Yes, God has name, but the names are so many that you cannot understand which one is the chief name. Therefore, the Vedantins, those who are expert in Vedic knowledge, and the word is also there, they have selected the chief name of God as Krishna. Krishna means all attributes. God has actually no name, but His name is designated according to His activities and actions, just like Partha Sarathi. Partha Sarathi, the name is given to Krishna because he acted as the chariot driver of power. He is addressed as Devaki Nandan. So Devaki Nandan is not his name, but because he acted, he appeared as the son of Devaki, he is called Devaki. He is called Jasodharana. Similarly, all the names of God, actually what you say that there is no name of God, but no name, he has his name, but the name is designated according to his activities. That means the God has his activities, and according to the different types of activities, he has got millions and trillions of names. So our, this propaganda, chant the holy name of God. So somebody may decline that why shall I chant the name of Krishna? This is Hindu name or Indian name. Yeah. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that if you decline to chant the particular name Krishna, then if you have got your name of God, you can chant that also. We are not dogmatic. If you have got actually the name of God, you chant that. That is his instruction. Nam namakari bahudha nidasatva shakti tattarvita niyamita smarane nakal. Itadisi tavokripa bhagavan mama pi durdaiva idrisameha janina anuda. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says that whatever name you select, God's name, in India we have got God's name in so many varieties, Krishna, Govinda, Narayana, Vishnu. But we selected to chant this Hare Krishna mantra because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the inaugurator of the Sankirtan movement, he personally chanted this Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So we follow Mahajana Jina Tatasya Pantha. We have to follow some authority. So our request is to everyone, I think there should be any objection, that if chant the holy name of God, this is Krishna consciousness movement. If you have got your own name of God, you chant that. If not, what is the objection? Take this name, Krishna, and chant. Why there should be objection? This is not dogmatic. We give freedom. We do not give. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives. That God has got many names. Why not? Just like one man in the family, somebody is calling him father, somebody calling him brother, somebody calling him by his name. There are so many ways to call the same man. Similarly, if you have got a name, holy name of the Holy Father, you chant that. This is our purpose. Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalo. This is the recommendation in the Vedic literature, that in this age of differentiation, this age of fight, quarreling, misunderstanding, if I say this is the name of God, and you say, no, this is the name of God, then they will fight. So better Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives that whatever name you have got, but it must be God's name. Hare Rama, not your manufactured name. It must be authorized God's name. You chant that. This is Krishna consciousness. And this is the basic principle of bhakti yoga. Krishna says here, yogam junjan madasraya. Yoga. Maya Saptamana. The business is that we have to increase our attachment for God. This is our main business. We are attached to so many things, that is material life. Everyone has God, therefore you have got different types of body. Karanam gunasanga asya sadasat janma jonishu. Why you have got different types of body? The karana, the reason is that we are associating with particular type of infection in this material world and you are getting particular type of body. I have explained it several times that there are three gunas, satagun, rajagun, tamak. So, Bhagavad Gita it is said, karanam guna sangasya. As soon as we are in the material world, we are under the influence either of these three gunas, satagun, rajagun, tamak. Those who are purely in association with the modes of goodness, satagun, they are considered as Brahman. And those who are associated with the rajagun, passion, they are called kshatriyas. And those who are associating with the tamogun, ignorant, they are called the shudras. And the mixture of tamogun and rajogun is the position of the Vaishya. In this way, there are four divisions of man everywhere. Chaturvarnam maya sristam guna karma vibhaga. According to the association of particular type of modes of nature and working in that way, it makes a division of the human society. That is required for upkeep of the human society in order according to the quality and work, there must be division. But that is not that division as we are thinking at the present moment in India. A man is born in the Brahmin family, he is Brahmin. No. He must have the Brahminical qualification. That is first considered. Sama, dama, satta, saucham, arjava, titikha, jnanam, vijnanam, astikam, brahma, karma, sabhava. That is the bhadita of this shastra, not by birth. Birth is a facility. If you have the opportunity to take birth in a brahmana family, then you have got the best opportunity to acquire the Brahminical qualification. Just like a person born as the son of a medical man, from the childhood he is learning all the medical terms and how his father is treating patient. So before entering medical college he is half medical man. That is the facility. But if we don't take the facility, we go astray. They are called Brahma Bandhu. And if we have acquired the qualification of a Shudra, then even though one is born in the Brahman family, he should be accepted as Shudra. Similarly, if a person is born in a Shudra family, but he has acquired these qualities, Sama, Dama, Satta, Saucham, he should be designated as Brahman. That is the injunction of the shastras in many places. So, if by force I want to assume myself as a brahmana, kshatriya, without qualification, that is the cause of India's cultural ruination. Such a high Vedic culture of India is now ruined because we have misused the term. That is the cause. Now, we are interested, but this culture, this Vedic culture, is not for, not meant for India. It is meant for all living entities. Sarvajonishu kaunteya sambhavanti mutrayaja. Krishna never claimed that I am the God of the Hindus, or I am Indian, or I am for the Brahmanas, or this, or that. No. He says that I am the seed-giving father of everyone. That is God. That is God. That means God. He never claimed. Sarvajonis. There are 8,400,000 species of life, and Krishna claimed to be the father, seed-giving father of all of them. So Krishna is for everyone. Don't take Krishna as sectarian. No. Krishna is God. He is for everyone. So if we want to know Krishna, then Krishna gives the formula. If you want to know God, then you follow God's formula. What is that? Maya saktamana pratha yogam jinnan madasa. First of all, first business is that you have to increase your attachment for God, for Krishna. We are increasing our attachment for the dog. And where is the attachment for God? People are becoming, now it has become a fashion to keep dogs and increase attachment for dogs. They are ready to kill cows but give protection to the dog. So our advancement of civilization is going in that way. Anyway, this attachment or that attachment, every particular man has got attachment for something, phobia. But that attachment should be turned for Krishna. This yoga has to be practiced. Maya sakta mana pratha yogam jinjan madasa. Then what will be the result? Asaṁsayam samagraṁ māp yathākāśasī tachinu. Asaṁsayam. We have got vague idea of God. We do not know actually what is God. There is saṁsaya, doubt. Somebody is impersonalist, somebody is localized, somebody is personalist. But actually, if we ask every man, what is your conception of God? I think hardly anyone will be able to explain what is the meaning of God. We have no clear idea. Is it not a fact? Can anyone of you give me a clear idea what you mean by God? No. Therefore, if you want clear idea of God, without any doubt, asaṁsaṁ, and samagraṁ, samagraṁ means full, not partial. The spiritual understanding is partial in this way. Brahmeti, Paramatmaiti, Bhagavaniti, Sabdate. The absolute truth is realized in three features. Brahma, beginning from Brahma. Then Paramatma, Super Soul. I think in Christian world they call Holy Ghost. Anyway, Paramatma, the Super Soul. And ultimately, the Supreme Personality of God, Krishna. That is the statement of the Shastra. Krishna su Bhagavan Sam. If you want to know, here is Bhagavan. In many other places, Ishara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadi Radi Govinda, Sarvakarana Karana. Sarvakarana karana. There is nothing accidental. Everything is there as cause and effect. That is clear idea. So, there are made so many causes. I am caused by my father is caused by his father is caused by his father. Go on, go on. Then you come to the Supreme Father. He is the cause of all things. That is Krishna. The Supreme Father is the cause of all subordinate powers. That is the definition of God, another definition. Ishvara Parama Krishna. Ishvara means controller. So controller, you are also controller. You control over your family, over your son, over your wife. And if you go to the office, you become controlled by your boss. So here, the controller is relative. Both, I am controller and control. But when you find somebody else, he is simply controller, not control. That is God. This is simple definition of God. You will find everyone relatively controller and control. But go on searching out, where is that person that he is controller but not controlled? That is Ishvara. That is Ishvara Parama, the Supreme. And who is that? Krishna. When Krishna was present, he was not controlled by anyone. He was only controller. If you study the life of Krishna, you will find he is always controller, never controlled by anyone. Therefore the Shastra says, Ishvara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha. And about his form, this form is Satchidananda. How it is? Then you can distinguish your form, this body, is asap, it will not stay. But Krishna's form is sap, just the opposite. And your form and my form is full of ignorance, not chit. But Krishna's form is full of knowledge. Just opposite. And ananda, my form is so full of miserable condition of life that I have no ananda, blissfulness. But Krishna's form is blissfulness. You'll find Krishna's picture always smiling and playing on his flute with his coward boy friends or the gopis or his maharajas, always joy. Ananda. Anandamaya Vyasat. That is the Vedanta Sutra says. The absolute truth by nature is anandamaya, always jolly. So if we become in touch with that anandamaya, that is called self-realization. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma. You get the same qualification. Just like if you touch yourself with fire, you get the quality of fire. You become warm. In any way, come to the fire, you become warm. Similarly, samaya raja, you come to Krishna, that is called maya asaktamana. Samaya raja, you become attached to Krishna. This yoga has to be practiced. That is called bhakti yoga. Jena teno prakarena mana krishna nivesaye. This is the injunction given by the Goswami. Samavarada. Kamat, krodhat, bhayat. There are so many ways. One is attached to Krishna by lusty desire. Just like the gopis. The gopis saw Krishna, very young boy, very beautiful. Naturally young girls become attached to beautiful boy. So they became attached. The attachment is there, maya saptama. Kamsa, out of fearfulness, because he heard that Krishna will kill him. So he was always thinking of Krishna, whether Krishna is coming to kill me, whether Krishna is coming to kill me. So he also became attached. Bhayat, kamat, bhayat, krodhat. There are so many examples. So these are indirect attachment and direct attachment. Just think of what is the result of direct attachment. If by indirect attachment they become so exalted, when you become directly attached with Krishna by love, just see what is your position. So that is Krishna consciousness movement. Maya Satyamana Pratha Yogam Jinnad Madasa. So this has to be done under the direction of Madasa, a person, a devotee, or the spiritual master who has absolutely taken shelter of Krishna. He is also Madasa. He has no other business. So either take the shelter of the person or directly the Supreme Person, the same thing. Better to take the shelter of a person who is under the protection of Krishna. So our request is that Bhagavad Gita is very popular book. Don't try to interpret Bhagavad Gita whimsically, just to show yourself a big scholar and big politician. No, don't do that. Try to understand Bhagavad Gita as it is. Then you will be very good. Therefore, you are presenting Bhagavad Gita, this book, it is 1100 pages. We are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is, without any interpretation. And the result is that thousands of the foreign country youths, they are becoming Krishna conscious. The proof is there. The proof is there. And all over the world, Europe, America, Canada, Australia, Japan, even in Moscow, and Africa, everywhere. We are not failure. That is Krishna's grace. Because we are presenting Krishna as it is, Bhagavad Gita as it is being accepted. Before me, many Swamis went to the Western countries. They also talked about Bhagavad Gita and other Vedic literature. But not a single person could be converted to Krishna consciousness. Not a single person. Throughout the whole history, background. But since 1967, we are presenting Bhagavad Gita as it is. Thousands of young generations that are taking to Krishna consciousness. This is the result. So, either we remain in Fiji or in England or anywhere, because Krishna is the proprietor of everything, everywhere. Sarva Loka Maheshwara. So Fiji is a small part of the Sarva Loka. So if he is the proprietor of all the lokas, then he is the proprietor of Fiji also. There is no doubt about it. So the inhabitants of Fiji, if you take to Krishna consciousness, that is the perfection of life. That is the perfection of life. Don't deviate from the instruction of Krishna. Very directly, Bhagavan was. Directly Bhagavan is speaking. Take advantage of, there is solution of all problems of the world. If you refer to Bhagavad Gita. Any problem you present, there is solution. Provided you take the solution. Nowadays, they are facing scarcity of food. The solution is there in the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says, annad bhavanti bhutani. Bhutani, all living entities, both animal and man, they can live very nicely without any anxiety, provided they have got sufficient food grains. Now what is your objection to this? This is the solution. Krishna says, annar bhavanti bhutani. It is not utopia, it is practical. You must have sufficient food grains to feed the human being and the animal, and everything will be peaceful immediately. Because people, if one becomes hungry, he is disturbed. So give him food, first of all. That is Krishna's injunction. Is that very impossible, impractical? No. You grow food more and distribute. So much land is there. But we are not growing food. We are busy in manufacturing tools and motor cars. Then now eat motor cars. But Krishna says that you grow anna. Then there is no question of scarcity. Anna bhavanti bhutani. Parjannat anna sambhava. But anna is produced when there is sufficient rain. Parjannat anna sambhava. And jagya bhavati parjanna. And if you perform jagya, then there will be regular rainfall. This is the way. But nobody is interested in jagya. Nobody is interested in food grant. And if you create your own scarcity, then it is not God's fault, it is your fault. So take anything, any question, social, political, philosophical, religious, anything you take, and the solution is there. Just like India is now facing about this caste system. So many are in favor of the caste system, so many not. But Krishna makes the solution. There is no question of in favor or not in favor. The caste system should be designated according to the quality. Chatur Varnam Maya system, guna karma, never says by birth. And in the Srimad Bhagavatam it is confirmed, jasahi jat lakshanam proktam varnami vanyakam jadi annatravi disheta tatte naivamini disheta. Clear instruction of Narad Muni. So, we have got everything perfectly in the Vedic literature. And if we follow the Krishna consciousness movement, he is trying to educate people on this principle. We are not manufacturing anything. That is not our need. Because we know we are imperfect. Even if we manufacture something, there is imperfect. We have got four faults in our condition and life. We commit mistake. We become illusion. We cheat others. And our senses are imperfect. So how we can get perfect knowledge from a person who is, possessing all these faults? Therefore we must get knowledge from the Supreme Person who is not affected with these faults, Mukta Purusha. That is perfect knowledge. So our request is that you take knowledge from Bhagavad Gita and act accordingly. It doesn't matter what you are. Bhagavan is for everyone. God is God. Just like gold is gold, if gold is handled by Hindu, it does not become Hindu gold. Or the gold is handled by Christian, it does not become Christian gold. Gold is gold. Similarly, dharma is one. Religion is one. There cannot be Hindu religion, Muslim religion, Christian religion. That is artificial. Just like Hindu gold, Muslim gold. That is not possible. Gold is gold. Similarly, religion. Religion means the law given by God. That is religion. Dharmant Sakshad Bhagavat Pranitam. Navi Vidu Devata Manusha, like that. I just forget. That dharma, this principle of dharma, religious system, is ordained or given by God. So God is one. Therefore, dharma and religious system should be one. There cannot be two. That one religion is given in the Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam vraja. To surrender to God, the great, and to abide by His instruction, that is called religion. It may be that the Hindus may be following the same principle in a different way, or the Christian may be following the same principle in a different way. That is called desha-kala-patra, according to time, atmosphere, and the performer. There may be little difference. But real purpose of dharma is to surrender to God and try to love Him. That is dharmant-sakshad-bhagavat-punyam. Sabai pungsang paro dharma jato bhakti adhukkari. Because we are part and parcel of God, we have not forgotten. We have to revive our God consciousness. Then we go back to home, back to God. This is our business. So Krishna consciousness movement is meant for this purpose, that everyone should be raised to the platform of God consciousness. Then his human form of life is successful. Otherwise, it is the life of cats and dogs. Thank you very much.